Dear friends, I am Dr. K. Kannan, Professor Mechanical Engineering, Anjali Ammal Mahalingam Engineering College, Koyilvanni. I am happy to meet you again in the video lecture on the topic gas power cycles. This is lecture number 10 on the gas power cycle, and we are going to solve problems on the dual cycle. And at the end of the lecture, the student will be able to solve problems on the dual cycle. So we take problem only from the anionistic question paper, so that the student will get the confident of solving anionistic question paper. And in the earlier lecture, we discussed the theory part of the dual cycle. So before you listen to this video, you kindly go through the theory part of the dual cycle, the derivation of the efficiency, the relationship between pressure and volume and temperature in various processes, a definition of pressure ratio, definition of the cutoff ratio, everything you have to be familiar to solve the problem. We take the first problem from the anionistic question paper, November 2009. In an engine working on dual cycle, the temperature and the pressure at the beginning of the cycle are 90 degrees Celsius and 1 bar respectively. The compression ratio is 9. The maximum pressure is limited to 68 bar and the total heat supplied per kg of air is 1750 kilojoules. Determine pressure and temperature at all salient points, air standard efficiency and mean effective pressure. So we write down the given data, temperature T1 equal to 90 degrees Celsius, which is 363 Kelvin, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar at the beginning, the compression ratio R equal to V1 by V2 equal to 9, the maximum pressure is P3 equal to P4 equal to 68 bar, and the total heat supplied is 1750 kilojoules per kilogram. We take the following properties of air. The properties are not given in the problem. Cp equal to 1.004 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and Cv equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, R gas constant R equal to 0.287 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and gamma equal to 1.4. Now for the isentropic compression process, so we take the PV diagram of the dual cycle. So 1 to 2 isentropic compression process, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition process, 3 to 4 constant pressure heat addition process, and 4 to 5 isentropic expansion process, 5 to 1 constant volume heat rejection process. So for the first process, isentropic compression process, we calculate the pressure and temperature, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, where P1 into V1 by V2 equal to R. So P1 into R to the power gamma equal to 1 into 9 to the power 1.4 equal to 21.67 bar, and temperature T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, where again V1 by V2 equal to R. So T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1 equal to 363 into 9 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 874.4 Kelvin. Then we take the constant volume heat addition process. So we have to calculate P3 RP pressure ratio, RP equal to P3 by P2. So P3 is given in the problem, 68 bar. So 68 divided by 21.67 equal to 3.14. And temperature T3 equal to T2 into P3 by P2. Substitute the numerical value is 874.2 into 3.14 equal to 2745 Kelvin. Now we calculate the heat addition at the constant volume process. So QCV equal to CV into T3 minus T2. So 0.717 into 2745 minus 874.2 equal to 1341.36 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, the constant pressure heat addition process. So, we are given the total heat addition is 1750 kilojoules per kilogram. So, heat supply, total heat supplied equal to QCV plus QCP. So, heat addition constant volume plus heat addition constant pressure. So, we have calculated QCV 1341.36 plus CP into T4 minus T3. So, the CP into T4 minus T3 equal to 1750 minus 1341.36 equal to 408.64. Now, substitute the numerical values. CP equal to 1.004. T4 is the unknown. T3 we calculated earlier, 2745 equal to 408.64. So the temperature T4 equal to 3153.64 Kelvin. Then we calculate the cutoff ratio, RC equal to V4 by V3 equal to T4 by T3, which is 3153.64 divided by 2745 equal to 1.15. So to calculate the efficiency, we require the cutoff ratio and the pressure ratio. So we have to refer to every process and the parameters we have to calculate. Next, we take the isentropic expansion process. So we calculate the temperature T5 and P5, pressure P5. So T5 equal to T4 into V4 by V5. So V4 by V5 to the power gamma minus 1. And this V4 by V5 equal to RC by R. RC is the cutoff ratio, R is the compression ratio. So this derivation is available in the theory part. So you can refer to it. But anyhow, you remember T4 into RC by R to the power gamma minus 1. So substitute the numerical value is 3153.64 into 1.15 divided by 9 to the power 1.4 minus 1. So calculating the T5 equal to 1384.8 Kelvin. And the P5 equal to P4 into V4 by V5 to the power gamma. So P4 into RC by R to the power gamma, which is 64 into 1.15 divided by 9 to the power 1.4 equal to 3.8 bar. Now we calculate the air standard efficiency. The equation efficiency of dual cycle equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1. And remember, carefully remember, RP RC to the power gamma minus 1. Then divided by RP minus 1 plus gamma into RP into RC minus 1. So this equation you have to remember. So when you solve few more problems repeatedly, use the equation, then you can remember the equation. So eta dual efficiency, dual cycle efficiency equal to substituting all the numerical values, 1 minus 1 by 9 to the power 1.4 minus 1 multiplied by numerator 3.14 into 1.15 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by RP equal to 3.14 minus 1 plus 1.4, gamma equal to 1.4, RP equal to 3.14, RC equal to 1.15 minus 1. So calculating, use the calculator carefully and calculate the value. The efficiency is 0.5819, that is equal to 58.19%. Then we calculate the specific volume, small V1 equal to RT1 by P1 from the perfect gas equation. So 0.287 into 363 divided by 100 equal to 1.042 metric cube per kilogram. And the small V2 specific volume at the end of the compression process, V1 by R compression ratio. So 1.042 divided by 9 equal to 0.116 metric cube per kilogram. Now we calculate the swept volume. So Vs equal to V1 minus V2. This is 1.042 minus 0.116 equal to 0.926 metric cube per kilogram. Then we calculate the work done. So work done during this process, W equal to eta into Qs, which is 0.5819 into 1750 equal to 1018.32 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the mean effective pressure. So MEP equal to net work done divided by the swept volume V1 minus V2. So 1018.32 divided by 0.926 equal to 1099.7 kilopascal. Then we write down the answers to the problem. So pressure and temperature at all salient points. Pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 21.67 bar, P3, P4 equal to 68 bar, and P4 equal to 3.8 bar. T1 equal to 363 Kelvin, T2 equal to 874.2 Kelvin, T3 equal to 2745 Kelvin, and T4 equal to 3153.84 Kelvin, and T5 equal to 1384.8 Kelvin. The theoretical air standard efficiency is 58.19% and the mean effective pressure is 1099.7 kilopascal. The next problem, example number 2, the compression ratio of an air standard dual cycle is 12 and the maximum pressure in the cycle is limited to 70 bar. The pressure and temperature of the cycle at the beginning of the compression process are 1 bar and 300 Kelvin. Assume heat supply and constant volume is equal to constant pressure. Calculate the thermal efficiency and mean effective pressure. Assume the cylinder bore 250 mm, stroke length equal to 300 mm, You take Cp equal to 1.005 and Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this question is from May 2010 question paper. So, we write down the given data. So, the compression ratio R equal to 12, P3 equal to P4 equal to 70 bar, P1 equal to 1 bar, T1 equal to 300 Kelvin, diameter equal to 250 millimeter, which is 0.25 meter. Stroke length equal to 300 millimeter, which is 0.3 meter. Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And we calculate gamma, which is 1.4. Gamma equal to Cp by Cv equal to 1.4. And we calculate the swept volume from the dimensions of the cylinder. So Vs equal to pi by 4 d square into L. So, pi by 4 into 0.25 square into 0.3 equal to 0.0142 meter cube. Then using the compression process, isentropic compression process, we refer to the PV diagram. 1 to 2 isentropic compression, 2 to 3 constant volume heat addition, 3 to 4 constant pressure heat addition, 4 to 5 isentropic expansion, and 5 to 1 constant volume heat rejection. So, first for the isentropic compression process, we calculate the pressure and temperature at the end of the compression process. So, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma. So, already we told V1 by V2 equal to R. So, P1 into R to the power gamma equal to 1 into 12 to the power 1.4 equal to 32.42 bar. And T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1. So, 300 into 12 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 810.6 Kelvin. Now, for constant volume heat addition, so we have Rp, we calculate Rp, pressure ratio Rp equal to P3 by P2, so 70 divided by 32.42 equal to 2.16, and T3 we calculate, so T3 equal to T2 into P3 by P2, so T2 is 810.6 into 2.16 equal to 1750.9 Kelvin, and we calculate the heat addition at constant volume. So, Cv into T3 minus T2, which is 0.718 into 1750.9 minus 810.6 equal to 675.1 kilojoules per kilogram. So, the heat addition at constant volume is 675.1 kilojoules per kilogram. Now, we are given heat addition at constant pressure is equal to heat addition at constant volume. So, QCV equal to QCP equal to 675.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And we have QCP equal to CP into T4 minus T3, which is 675.1 kilojoules per kilogram. And the substitute numerical values 1.005 into T4 minus 1750.9 equal to 670.1. So, calculating T4 equal to 2422.64 Kelvin. Then we calculate the cutoff ratio. Cutoff ratio equal to V4 by V3, which is T3 by T4. So, for constant pressure heat addition process, we have to calculate the cutoff ratio. So, 2422.64 divided by 1750.9 equal to 1.38. So, cutoff ratio equal to 1.38. And the cycle efficiency. So, we write down the given data, write down the equation carefully once again. 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into Rp into Rc to the power gamma minus 1 divided by Rp minus 1 plus gamma into Rp into Rc minus 1. You substitute the numerical values 1 minus 1 by 12 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 2.16. Rp equal to 2.16 into Rc equal to 1.38. So, 2.16 into 1.38 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by Rp minus 1, 2.16 minus 1 plus gamma Rp, gamma equal to 1.4, Rp equal to 2.16 into 1.38 minus 1. So, calculating the efficiency is 0.6425 or 64.25%. And we calculate the mass of the air from the swept volume, given swept volume, we calculate the mass of the air. So, V1 specific volume at before the compression process RT1 by P1. Which is 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.861 meter cube per kilogram. And V2 specific volume, V2 equal to V1 by R. So, 0.861 divided by 12 equal to 0.07175 meter cube per kilogram. So, mass equal to swept volume divided by V1 minus V2 specific volume, change in the specific volume. So, 0.0142 swept volume already we calculated divided by 0.816 minus 0.07175 equal to 0.019 kilogram. Now we calculate the work done. So work done equal to eta into QS equal to 0.6425 into 2 into 675.1. So QS equal to QQCV plus QCP. So 2 into 675.1 equal to 867.5 kilojoules per kilogram. And the mean effective pressure equal to mass into work done divided by swept volume 0.019 into 867.5 divided by 0.0142 equal to 1160.74 kilopascal. So we write down the answer. The thermal efficiency is 64.15% and the mean effective pressure is 1160.74 kilopascal. So we take the example number 3, and this is from November 2012 question paper from Anna University. An air standard dual cycle has the compression ratio of 18 and the compression begins at 1 bar and 40 degree Celsius. The maximum pressure is 85 bar. The heat transfer to air at constant pressure is equal to that of at the constant volume. Estimate pressure and temperature at all cardinal points of the cycle, cycle efficiency, mean effective pressure of the cycle. So, we write down the given data. R equal to 18, compression ratio equal to 18, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, temperature T1 equal to 40 degree Celsius, which is 313 Kelvin, and P3 equal to P4, maximum pressure P3 equal to P4 equal to 85 bar, and we are given heat addition at constant volume is equal to heat addition at constant pressure. So, we calculate the specific volume for the compression process. Small V1 equal to RT1 by P1, so 0.287 into 313 divided by 100 equal to 0.8983 meter cube per kilogram, and V2 specific volume, V2 equal to V1 by R compression ratio, so 0.8983 divided by 18 equal to 0.05 meter cube per kilogram. And we take the isentropic compression process. So we draw the pressure volume diagram. In your examination, always draw the PV diagram with a pencil, that is very important. P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, so where P1 into V1 by V2 equal to R to the power gamma, so it is 1 into 18 to the power 1.4 equal to 57.2 bar. T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, so where T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1 equal to R to the power gamma minus 1, so it is 313 into 18 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 994.6 Kelvin. And for constant volume heat addition process, first we calculate the pressure ratio RP, so P3 by P2. So we are given P3 equal to 85 bar and P2 we calculated 57.2. So the pressure ratio is 1.49. Then we calculate the temperature T3 equal to T2 into P3 by P2, so which is 994.6 into 1.49 equal to 1481.95 Kelvin. Then we calculate the heat addition at constant volume QCV equal to CV into T3 minus T2, which is 0.717 into 1481.95 minus 994.6 equal to 349.4 kilojoules per kilogram. So, for the constant volume, so every process, please remember, for every process we have to calculate all the parameters. So the for constant volume process we have to calculate the pressure ratio, then constant pressure process we have to calculate the cutoff ratio, then for constant pressure heat addition process, so we are given in the problem QCP equal to QCV, so CP into T4 minus T3 equal to 349.4. So, substituted numerical value is 1.004 into T4 minus 1481.95 equal to 349.4. So, we calculate the T4 equal to 1830 Kelvin. And we calculate the cutoff ratio V4 by V3 equal to T4 by T3. This is 1830 divided by 1481.95 equal to 1.23. Cutoff ratio equal to 1.23. And for isentropic expansion process, we calculate the pressure and temperature at the end of the isentropic expansion process, P5 and T5. So, T5 equal to T4 into V4 by V5 to the power gamma minus 1. So, this V4 by V5 equal to RC by R. And for derivation, you refer to the theory video. The T4 into RC by R to the power gamma minus 1, this is 1830 into 1.23 divided by 18 to the power 1.4 minus 1. Equal to 625.6 Kelvin, and the P5 equal to P4 into V4 by V5 to the power gamma, which is P4 into RC by R to the power gamma, which is 85 into 1.23 divided by 18 to the power 1.4, which is 1.99 bar. And we calculate the air standard efficiency of the cycle, dual cycle. So, eta equal to 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RP into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by RP minus 1 plus gamma into RP into RC minus 1. So, substituting all the numerical values, 1 minus 1 by 18 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 1.49 into 1.23. RP equal to 1.49, RC equal to 1.23 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.49 minus 1 plus 1.4 into 1.49 into 1.23 minus 1. So, calculating 0.6784, the efficiency is 67.84%. Then we calculate the work done. So, work done W equal to eta into heat supplied. So, 0.6784 into heat supplied equal to 2 times of 349.4 equal to 474.07 kilojoules per kilogram, and the mean effective pressure is net to work done divided by V1 minus V2, that is swept volume, that is equal to 474.07 divided by 0.8983 minus 0.05 equal to 558.8 kilopascal. Then we write down the answers to the problem. The pressure and temperature, all the salient points, pressure in bar, temperature in Kelvin. So, P1 equal to 1 bar, P2 equal to 57.2 bar, P3 equal to 85, P4 equal to 85 given in the problem, P5 equal to 1.99 bar, and T4 equal to 313 Kelvin, T2 equal to 994.6 Kelvin, T3 equal to 1481.95 Kelvin, and T4 equal to 1830 Kelvin, and T5 equal to 625.6 Kelvin. So, theoretical air standard efficiency is 67.84%, and the mean effective pressure is 558.8 kilopascal. Then we take the example number 4. In an engine working on dual cycle, the heat supplied at constant pressure is twice that of heat supplied at constant volume. So, the compression and expansion ratio is 8 and 5.3. The pressure and temperature at the beginning of the cycle are 0.93 bar and 27 degrees Celsius. Find the efficiency of the cycle and the mean effective pressure. We take Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And this question is from November 2012 question paper. So, we write down the given data. Heat addition at constant pressure equal to 2 times of heat addition constant volume. R equal to 8. Compression ratio equal to 8. Expansion ratio equal to 5.3. Re is the expansion ratio 5.3. Pressure P1 equal to 0.93 bar. P1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin. Cp equal to 1.005 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. And Cv equal to 0.718 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin. So, we calculate the specific volume for the compression process. So, small V1 equal to RT1 divided by P1, which is 0.287 into 300 divided by 0.93 bar, we take 93 kilopascal, so which is 0.926 meter cube per kilogram. So, here denominator, so small V2 equal to V1 by R equal to 0.926 divided by 8 equal to 0.116 meter cube per kilogram. And we take the isentropic compression process. So, with reference to the PV diagram of the dual cycle, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma, which is P1 into R to the power gamma, which is 0.93 into 8 to the power 1.4 equal to 17.1 bar. T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power gamma minus 1, which is T1 into R to the power gamma minus 1, which is 300 into 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 equal to 689.2 Kelvin. Then the cutoff ratio. We calculate the cutoff ratio. We are given the compression ratio and the expansion ratio. From these two ratios, we calculate the cutoff ratio. So, refer to the, just listen to the equation. R equal to V1 by V2, RE equal to V5 by V4. So, divide by R by RE equal to V1 by V2 divide by V5 by V4. So, that is equal to V1 by V2 into V4 by V5. Now, we change V1 as it is, V2 equal to V3. and V4 as it is, V5 equal to V1. So, finally, V1, V1 getting cancelled, this becomes V4 by V3. So, V4 by V3 equal to RC. So, RC equal to R by RE. This you have to remember. Cutoff ratio equal to the compression ratio divided by the expansion ratio. This is V4 by V3, which is 8 divided by 5.3 equal to 1.51. So, from the given information, we have to calculate the cutoff ratio. That you have to be familiar. That you have to be clearly understand. And we calculate QCP equal to 2 times of QCV. So, CP into T4 minus T3 equal to 2CV into T3 minus T2. So, CP into T3 into T4 by T1 minus 1 equal to 2CV into T3 into 1 minus T2 by T3. Now, look at the equation 1.005. T3 is getting cancelled. So, T4 by T3 as it is minus 1. 2 into CV equal to 0.718. into 1 minus 689.2 divided by T3. Now, this T4 by T3 equal to V4 by V3. So, in the earlier derivation, we derived V4 by V3 equal to 1.51. So, T4 by T3, V4, T4 by T3 equal to V4 by V3 and the remaining part is as it is. Then, we substitute for V4 by V3. So, 1.005 into 1.51 minus 1, this equal to 2.0718. into 1 minus 689.2 divided by T3. So, the value 1 minus 689.2 divided by T3 equal to solving 0.366. Now, solving this equation, T3 equal to 1087.1 Kelvin. So, from the given information, what is the given information? We are given QCP equal to QCV. We derive the temperature, calculate the temperature T3. Then for constant volume heat addition process, so P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2, so 17.1 into 1087.1 divided by 689.2 equal to 26.97 bar and RP we calculate P3 by P2 which is 26.97 divided by 17.1 equal to 1.58 and we calculate the heat addition constant volume CV equal to CV into T3 minus T2 which is 0.718 into 1087.1. minus 689.2 equal to 285.7 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the total heat supply QS equal to CV plus CP. So, this is 285.7. So, QCP equal to 2 times of heat addition constant volume. So, 2 into 285.7 equal to 857.1 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the dual cycle efficiency, we write down the equation. So, 1 minus 1 by R to the power gamma minus 1 into RP into RC to the power gamma minus 1 divided by RP minus 1 plus gamma into RP into RC minus 1. So, substituting all the numerical values 1 minus 1 by 8 to the power 1.4 minus 1 into 1.58 into 1.51 to the power 1.4 minus 1 divided by 1.58 minus 1 plus 1.4 into 1.58 into 1.51 minus 1. So, calculating the value, this is 0.538, which is 53.8%. And the work done equal to eta into heat supplied. So, 0.538 into 857.1 equal to 461.12 kilojoules per kilogram. And the mean effective pressure is net to work done divided by the swept volume V1 minus V2. So, 461.12 divided by 0.926 minus 0.116 equal to 569.3 kilopascal. Now, answer to the problem, thermal efficiency is 53.8 and the mean effective pressure is 569.3 kilopascal. We take the example number 5 from the November 2017 question paper. An oil engine works on dual cycle, the heat liberated at constant pressure being twice that liberated at constant volume. The compression ratio of the engine is 8 and the expansion ratio is 5.3. But the compression and expansion process follow the law PV to the power 1.3 equal to constant. So, earlier the same earlier problem, the only difference is earlier PV to the power 1.4 equal to constant, but here in this problem PV to the power 1.3 equal to constant. The pressure and temperature at the beginning of the compression process are 1 bar and 27 degree Celsius respectively. Assume CP equal to 1.004 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin and CV equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin for air. Find the air standard efficiency and mean effective pressure. So we write down the given data. So QCP equal to 2 into QCV, R equal to 8, expansion ratio equal to 5.3, pressure P1 equal to 1 bar, temperature T1 equal to 27 degrees Celsius, which is 300 Kelvin, CP equal to 1.004 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and CV equal to 0.717 kilojoules per kilogram Kelvin, and N, polytropic index N equal to 1.3. So we calculate the specific volume. So specific volume is RT1 by P1, V1 equal to RT1 by P1, 0.287 into 300 divided by 100 equal to 0.861 meter cube per kilogram, and V2 equal to V1 by R, which is 0.861 divided by 8 equal to 0.1076 meter cube per kilogram. And for the isentropic compression process, with reference to the pressure volume diagram, P2 equal to P1 into V1 by V2 to the power N, which is P1 into R to the power N. So here N equal to 1.3. So 1 into 8 to the power 1.3 equal to 14.93 bar. And similarly, T2 equal to T1 into V1 by V2 to the power N minus 1, which is T1 into R to the power N minus 1 equal to 300 into 8 to the power 1.3 minus 1 equal to 559.82 Kelvin. And the cutoff ratio derivation, so already we discussed R by RE. Ratio of compression ratio to the expansion ratio equal to cutoff ratio. So, RC equal to R by RE, which is V4 by V5. So, 8 by 5.3 equal to 1.51. Then we use the same derivation. So, QCP equal to 2 times of QCV, CP into T4 minus T3, which is 2 into CV into T3 minus T2. So, we take T3 outside, CP into T3 into T4 by T3 minus 1. 2CV into T3 into 1 minus T2 by T3, and this T3 is getting cancelled. So 1.005 T4 by T3 minus 1 equal to 0.717 into 1 minus 559.82 divided by T3. Now T4 by T3 equal to V4 by V3. So substituting, so 1.005 into 1.51 minus 1 equal to 2 into 0.717 into 1 minus 559.82 divided by T3. And solving this equation, T3 equal to 870.6 Kelvin. And for a constant volume heat addition process, we calculate P3 equal to P2 into T3 by T2. So 14.93 into 870.6 divided by 559.82 equal to 23.22 bar. And the pressure ratio RP equal to P3 by P2, which is 23.22 divided by 14.93 equal to 1.56. And we calculate the heat addition at constant volume. So, CV into T3 minus T2. So, 0.717 into 870.6 minus 559.82 equal to 222.83 kilojoules per kilogram. Then we calculate the total heat supplied. So, QS equal to QCV plus QCP. So, 222.83 plus 2 into 222.83 equal to 668.49 kilojoules per kilogram. Then the efficiency of the dual cycle. So we write down the equation 1 minus 1 by R to the power N minus 1. So RP into RC to the power N minus 1 divided by RP minus 1 into N into RP into RC minus 1. So this gamma is replaced by N in the equation. So substitute the numerical values 1 minus 1 by 8 to the power 1.3 minus 1 into 1.56 into 1.51 to the power 1.3 minus 1 divided by 1.56 minus 1 plus 1.3 into 1.56 into 1.51 minus 1, calculating the value 0.44, which is 44%. Then we calculate the work done. So work done equal to eta, efficiency in the heat supply. So 0.44 into 668.49, which is 294.13 kilojoules per kilogram, and the mean effective pressure, which is net to work done divided by the swept volume. So 294.13 divided by 0.861 minus 0.1076 equal to 390.4 kilopascal. Then we write down the answer to the problem. Thermal efficiency equal to 44% and mean effective pressure is 390.4 kilopascal. We stop here. And these are all the books I referred for preparing the slides. I have published a book on thermal engineering. You can also refer to it. The other books also you can refer for your preparation and more problem on the dual cycle. And these are all the books I published. So you can refer to it. Design of transmission system, turbo emissions, heat and mass transfer, operations research, gas dynamics and jet propulsion, thermal engineering, fluid mechanics and machinery. Also, I have a YouTube channel where I upload the video lectures of all the subjects mentioned here and the solution to the mechanical engineering question paper from the GATE also uploaded in the YouTube channel. You can refer to it for your better learning and to pass in the GATE examination. So the video lectures will help the student. So if you use the video lectures effectively, you can learn the subject in a better way. And thank you for watching. You can please post your comments on the comments box. You subscribe the channel so that you will get the updated videos on the particular subject on the channel. You can write to me to my mail ID or contact through my WhatsApp number for any clarification on the subject. I will sincerely help you. So thank you for watching. So we'll meet again in the next video with additional problems from the dual cycle.